me and them, my two little poochie pooches, we're off to the forest. We're going to go for a quick, run slash jog slash walk. And, get some exercise. It's been raining here for the last couple of days, so we haven't gotten out much up into the forest. And today, it looks like it's going to be sort of sunny. Got bogeys up my nose. Anyway,
we are off to the forest to go for a run. Have a good day. We'll check in with you later. Bye.
So the title of this blog is Finding Balance, and at the end we do a shoulder workout. So I just want to, take a moment to say that finding and creating balance in your life is so important to being grounded. So this, to me, finding a bit of balance is getting out and about and exercising every day, and definitely going for some cardiovascular exercise like walking or running in a place like a forest does that for me. And over the years I've tried lots and lots of other different methods as well, and this one is, always something that I resort back to. On the next vlog I'll show you a tool that I used when life was a bit chaotic about how I did find balance and figured out what was out of whack and where I needed to work on. Just sort of doing a bit of, like I said, walk run. Turned into a bit more of a walk than a run because my calves are really, really tight. I just almost feel like they're going to cramp. I don't know why I sort of suffer with this issue, but yeah, every now and then it comes on quite badly, and it's annoying, really annoying. And I've tried compression socks and they don't seem to do the trick, and I take magnesium and it doesn't seem to work. And I just sort of put it down to the fact that I've got really short calf muscles, so they hold a lot of pressure in there. But if anybody else has got some solutions to tight calf muscles that feel like they're going to cramp when they're put under pressure, then leave a comment and let me know what your tricks are. Thanks.
Hearts alive, firestorms, and when they strike, we feel the love.
So starting off at the gym now, guys, and a Tabata workout is a set of exercises that you perform for a timed limit. So we've done 5 different exercises and we've done 4 rounds, 40 seconds on each exercise, and then we rest and repeated. And we repeated that for 4 rounds. Like it said, it was incline dumbbell curls and then straightened dumbbell lateral raises, and then barbell bicep curls, dumbbell front raises, and I'm performing here now, and then skipping. So it's important that on the skip you make sure that you keep your arms real strict, so it's supposed to just really burn out your shoulders. Skip pretty fast there. Real fast. After that I moved on to a couple of other exercises, and we'd done some drop sets. So we picked 2 exercises. It was front raises and lateral raises. First we done heavy single arm dumbbell front raises and then lighter weights and used double arms. And then we moved on to heavy lateral raises and then light lateral raises. Again it was timed and we done 4 rounds of this.
I'm from A, you're from Y, perfect strangers in the night. Here we are, come together, to the world we'll testify. Our hearts alive, firestorms, and when they strike, we feel the love. Sparks will fly, they ignite our bones. And when they strike, we light up the world.
Another Tabata type style workout. Okay, so four different exercises targeting the biceps: standing cable bicep curl, dumbbell hammer curls, barbell bicep, and it's just a low pump, so just a quarter of the weight, and then skipping again. So we've done this four times, 30 seconds on each exercise, because our shoulders are pretty sore by now, and so we're just burning out. I don't always train like this. However, I do like to check it in every now and then just to switch things up and keep the body guessing. It's really effective. And then to finish off, we're doing standing military press and handstands against the wall. So this was 8 times, 20 seconds on each exercise, back to back. So 20 seconds handstands, 20 seconds military press, repeat 8 times. It was definitely a killer. To make me feel better. So this is the dinner I had, and it's quite a typical dinner for me. So it's obviously a really large volume salad, lots of fiber in there. I really, depending on my appetite, just have as much salad as I want. And then I'm having kumara tonight. Alternatively, I can have rice or pumpkin. And then my choice of protein for this evening was chicken, but I can have red meat or tuna or fish, white fish if I please as well. But tonight this is what I had, and I actually had pretty much the same thing for lunch as well. I personally really, really enjoy eating like this, and I do track all my macros because at the moment I'm in comp prep, so competition's on October the 7th, so every single calorie is already accounted for, so to hold myself accountable, I weigh everything, takes out all the guesswork.